Finally, there's the appendix to chapter 5, which deals with the clustering of standard errors. This is only relevant when you're working with data for multiple groups and multiple time periods. And it solely relates to the standard error around your estimated treatment effect, so it's not related to selection bias, so non-random selection to treatment. That's another issue. This is just about correct estimation of your standard errors. Now, the issue is that we implicitly assume when running our regressions that each observation in your data set is an independent draw from a sample. Whereas in practice, when you're working with data, with time series data from multiple groups, then it may well be that observation XT for subject I is related to observation XT minus 1 for the same subject. For instance, say that you're working with data for a couple of states and you're looking at unemployment, then within a certain state, unemployment last year is strongly related to unemployment this year. And so if that's the case, so if there is serial correlation of your observations, then that means that each observation in your data set contains less information compared to the situation where each observation is completely independent. And so you'll learn more about serial correlation econometrics too, actually. Now, what are you to do? Basically, what you should do is adjust your standard errors. Otherwise, you're likely to understate the standard errors, i.e. you are too likely to reject the null hypothesis of no effect. Now, you can do this in Stata, for instance, but also in other programs, by just including the option cluster after your regression command. So, for instance, you can cluster by city. Say that you have data by city for multiple time periods, then you can use this. We will do this actually in computer assignment 4B. At least we will discuss this. There are several issues related to clustering. One of the issues is that you should have a minimum number of subjects in your study. So your data consists of n times t, t being the time periods, but n, the rule of thumb is that it should be around 30, whereas the data in computer assignment 4B is 25. So the authors actually use an alternative approach to clustering, and that is something that we will not discuss. What you should remember is that whenever you use panel data and you use the difference in differences approach, then you may understate your standard errors, and that's something you can solve by clustering your data.